Honda Motor Company Japan has reported that its internal servers are under cyber attack, spreading a virus through the company's IT systems. This has resulted in a temporary shutdown of operations at the automaker's plants in Brazil, Turkey, and the United States. A total of 11 Honda plants were affected across the globe, and it includes both two-wheeler and four-wheeler manufacturing facilities. In India, Honda Cars reported that the cyber attacks did not impact its production. However, Honda Motorcycle and Scooter India, the Indian two-wheeler subsidiary of the manufacturer, has reported that it has had to make temporary adjustments to its production schedule across the various plants. Honda Two Wheelers India has 4 production facilities across the country. It is unclear at the moment if the vehicle production has taken a hit due to the cyber attack. The Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has announced a further extension of the validity of motor vehicle documents till the 30th of September 2020. This means all documents including the fitness certificate, permits, driving license, registration certificates that have expired on or any time after the 1st of February 2020 will remain valid till September 30th this year. This is to facilitate people who were unable to renew their documents due to the lockdown enforced due to the spread of the coronavirus. The deadline was previously until the 31st of July 2020. The ministry has also issued a notification relaxing the fee on renewals or additional fee till the 31st of July this year. The Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India has announced the withdrawal of the long-term motor insurance package plans for 3 or 5 years, including third-party insurance as well as own damage. This will come into effect from the 1st of August 2020. The insurance regulatory body decided to withdraw the long-term insurance package policy after noticing several issues and concerns related to the performance of these policies. Some of the reasons that compelled the organization to take this step are challenges in actuarial pricing for long-term own damage policies, difficulties in distribution of policies, an expensive proposition, and a possibility of owners selling their vehicles due to financial reasons or default in loans. IRDAI further said that the customers with such policies would be burdened with the same insurer if they get deficient service or if the calculation of no-claim bonus is not uniform.
We've had 15 years of sheer leadership bringing you the very best of the world of wheels. If you like the best, subscribe to our channel.